And let me, now I don't think these guys are shy, but I'm going to say something about them anyway. Cameron Ghassari is the chief executive officer. And we're talking about, guess what we're talking about here, okay? And he's been a senior care industry for some time and has extensive background in entrepreneurship as well as owning companies and forming them. He was the first one to join the One Heart Caregiver Services franchise family in March of 2015. Boy, you guys have really grown in 5 years. And established a new office in Beverly Hills later that year. I don't know whether that's his first or his second, but we'll ask him. Since that time, Cameron, and please tell me if I'm pronouncing the names wrong for any reason, because I know Arnold a lot more. Anyway, he developed his One Heart agency as a reliable premium care provider to the community and is passionate about providing the best care for seniors, and also has been volunteering his time and energy in several different causes to improve their quality of life. And Arnold Navarro is a managing director, or the managing director, and of One Heart Caregiver Services, Newport Beach. And he worked at One Heart Caregiver Services head office as senior client care manager. I think the first time Arnold I met was probably at a Susan Geffen. Remember, take that nursing home, yes, and shove it. And then when I did visit their office before it had moved. And he was regional liaison in all associated, assigned competitive markets, and is responsible for all respective cross-functional teamwork. And boy, that not only a mouthful, that's a lot of work. So he implements the company's circle of care unique concept, performing as a senior advisory in a senior, is what I should be saying, between elder clients, their family members, and conservators and trustees. And I imagine also that includes fiduciaries. He manages and monitors particularly well, in a periodic way, every case process and caregiver's work performance to consistently provide excellent senior care. Arnold regularly performs a training facilitator to provide training to attendees of One Heart Caregiver University, which is how they teach their people because they are so professional, and on-the-job training to caregivers. And that's kind of a cue for me to bring this up, which we will hopefully talk about and be able to invite people to. And see, there is even a picture of me before I lost my 80 pounds, and even Arnold won't recognize how skinny I am.
Yes.
So he's had 27 years he's had of solid corporate experience, including 18 years of experience in various senior management and directorship positions. So I will I want to just get on to these fellows themselves, because I don't think I can do as much justice as they can to themselves. So I'll just say, for people who aren't familiar with One Heart, and as you can see, I am, we're going to get into the services that you do, the challenges you have, and all of those good things. So I'll let you guys and pick between yourselves who wants to start introducing themselves.
Go. Okay, maybe I can start. I'll just introduce myself. I'm Arnold Navarro. I've worked for One Heart Corporate Office for 14 years, and now I co-own the One Heart Newport Beach together with our first franchisee and our number one franchisee, Cameron Gaspar.
Mm-hmm. It looks like, I don't know, Sean, is Arnold's face cut off there?
No, I think that camera.
No? Okay, I was just on my monitor then. Well, tough.
Do you have my video or not?
Yes.
Yes.
Oh, I didn't know.
Yeah, you're looking good.
We're doing all sorts of things.
Yeah. You guys are making me look old.
Yes.
Yes, I know you agreed with that right away, didn't you? I don't blame you. Anyway, gentlemen, go ahead and introduce yourselves and get going on our subject today, home health care, perhaps a little bit about franchising and that kind of, all of that good stuff we all need to talk about, especially in this weird time that we are living in.
So my name is Cameron Gastry, as you just said, and I acquired the franchise. I was the first one to acquire the franchisee right for One Heart Caregiver Services in 2015. And of course, I remember at that time, Arnold was the CCM and was extremely helpful to us in all sorts of training me and my client care managers and our caregivers. And so far, we did okay so far. I was happy with the support I was getting from the home office. And I guess some months ago, June or July, we decided to go with Arnold to open the office in Newport Beach.
That's not too far. Now, do you have an ocean view?
I'm sorry?
How's your ocean view?
I was just kidding. I know. It's okay.
I used to have when I had like 300 people working for me at one time, we used to say our office was in Newport Beach. It was not. It was actually in Santa Ana Heights, which is surrounded by Newport Beach. But, you know, you guys are much more honest than I was.
Our office is actually in Newport Beach. You're more than welcome to come and have lunch.
I would love to, and I will, as soon as I'm sure I can get around. You know, I had some health problems of my own, but that's not what we're here to talk about.
Yes.
So, you know, let me know if, you know, for people who are not real familiar with One Heart Caregiver Services, can you kind of fill it, and you or Arnold, it doesn't matter. Remember, we're all in this conversation.
Yeah.
So feel free to talk. Let's go over the excellent caregiver services that you do exactly.
Arnold, do you want to go ahead?
Okay. One Heart Caregiver Services is a non-medical home care agency wherein we provide assistance to individuals that will be needing personal care services, from assisting them from toileting, bathing, grooming, dressing, errands, and whatever physical activity that will be able to provide them. And One Heart Caregiver Services, we have our own caregiver university wherein we train our caregivers before they get to be deployed.
So it's not like going to Craigslist or finding a caregiver on the back of a cereal box, right?
No.
I mean, and you don't want to go to something like Craigslist. This is important. This is either for yourself or it's for a loved family member or your parents. You want to make sure that they're in good hands. And another thing we can get into is, what about those family members who are acting like caregivers, which maybe in some cases is great, in some cases is help, in some cases they don't know what they're doing, and they should have backup with a company like yours. But those people, they need to be relieved, don't they?
Yes.
Yes.
Cameron, please.
Yes, actually, we have been providing respite care.
Yeah, your respite care. Good name for it.
Because after a while, it gets really tiring. So, and then they don't really think of, you know, they see this as their own duty, the family members. So they have to provide care for mom or dad. But when they realize that there is a professional agency, somebody else can do it, it's a great relief for them. So we've experienced that they really appreciate, you know, somebody take this weight off their shoulder. Especially a lot of them live not close. For example, they live in LA, the parents is in Santa Ana, and they have to travel. They divide it between, you know, the duty, they divide it between the kids. So yes, that's one of the things that we've been doing so far.
Yeah, the most important one that we could really provide family members is peace of mind. Just like Cameron mentioned, if ever a family member lives like 2 hours away, the mind that the parents are being taken care of by One Heart Caregiver Services.
Yeah. Now let me get into it. Maybe this is in a way of a review or whatever, but. And as far as talking about an office in Newport Beach or Beverly Hills or Riverside or whatever, none of that really matters. People have, I think, the same needs and the same health concerns everywhere. But just to try to drill in a little, what would you say the challenges of caring for seniors, and maybe as important for you or other people thinking about getting into this field, what's the real fulfillment that you feel for this kind of service, no matter where it is? And either one of you can chime in on that one.
Cameron?
You have to have the passion of helping others. I mean, I'm not trying to brag or, you know, say we are.
But maybe you should brag a little. I mean, it's hard work, isn't it?
Yes. I mean, you have to be concentrated. You have to be dedicated to helping seniors. So that's, I mean, besides the business part, you have to be that type of person anyway. I mean, if you want, and remember, it's not like a 9-to-5 job. It's
no
responsibility. So if you don't have the passion, you don't have the dedication, it's not going to work.
So I
that's
take
the fulfillment
it's,
in its own.
I take it some of your people actually are either that you have one person or you have two or three different shifts of people who actually take care of someone who needs 24-hour monitoring, do you?
Yes, we do.
Yeah, and that's, boy, that's a lot of, well, that's great for the people that need the monitoring. A lot of work for you probably when it comes to even bookkeeping and all of that kind of thing. But if somebody has one of your franchises, they get help with all of that, right?
Yes.
So they, you know, they don't have to spend hours every night going over their accounting records and all of that kind of good stuff. And I think Arnold knows a little bit more about that and the university, right?
Yes. Actually, when I was a senior client care manager, I was also a field consultant for franchisee.
Mm-hmm.
Field consultant of Cameron. That's why I know Cameron for the last 6 years and some other franchisee like Las Vegas and South Bay area.
Yeah.
And Joel was still there in South Bay.
Yeah. You know... this isn't one thing I can, I think I've mentioned this so many times, I probably shouldn't again, but I really, really feel that old people, and I'm one of them, okay? Old people to survive retirement need to stay busy. And I'm sure there's probably some retired people that actually can call you and become part of your organization, either as a caregiver or if you have the ability and the want to actually open your own One Heart Caregiving Center or franchise, right?
Yes.
Yes.
Now, the thing, but let me ask you, do you agree that keeping busy is, it does keep people healthier?
Of course.
Yeah. Yeah, and I think another thing is, and, you know, I don't want to get into reverse mortgages in your time here because we're limited in time, but, you know, the reverse mortgage can get money to make you, to allow you to do that kind of thing, but also gives you a lot more freedom and some ways to handle these things. Importantly too, for a lot of people who need your services, they need to find ways to pay for them. I don't want to get into that too much right now, but you know, you guys can talk about this, and I'll be talking about that subject then. But before we go any further, let us know how people and listeners can get a hold of you, whether that's older people, younger people that need help with their older relatives or anything like that. How do we get a hold of you, both phone numbers, email addresses, and maybe even, well, websites?
Yes, they can call me anytime at 949-942-2323, or they can email me at arnold.n@oneheartcares.com. And I'm available 24/7. I could set an appointment even Saturdays and Sundays.
And go ahead and repeat those numbers and information one more time. We'll do it again later, but, you know, later is getting sooner all the time. Okay. Just like we're getting older all the time and we need help. Go ahead. Sorry to interrupt.
Okay, it's 949-942-2323. My email address is arnold.n@oneheartcares.com. And they can call
you.
Me 24/7.
Thank you, Arnold. Now I want to get into something really important, if it's okay with you guys. We're living in a really strange time. This is a period of time, I don't know, I thought I would live long enough for people to be able to go to a hotel on Mars. I thought that, you know, vacationing on the weekend on the moon would be no big thing.
But video caregiver.
Yeah, but I never, ever thought we'd be living through a pandemic like the COVID-19 pandemic that is here right now. So let's discuss, you know, both of you guys and all of us, how that affects your business operations and how you keep your senior, you know, clients and caregivers safe and protected during this difficult situation. And we can also talk about some tips you may have for just general public out there.
Cameron?
So we just have to adapt to the new abnormal.
So oh, boy, yeah.
We made sure that our caregivers are getting tested on a regular basis, wearing protection devices, masks, and gloves at all times. We used to assign one caregiver to more than one client. For example, if they were doing
right, yeah, I didn't think of that, but yeah.
But
yeah,
now we just give them only one client, you know, in order to keep them from getting the virus, less contact with, you know, with people. So you have to do whatever you can. And of course, you know, we send them information about washing their hands.
Right.
And keeping it clean and things like that. So this is the best we can do.
What you're doing, and I think by giving, by doing that change about one caregiver, about a caregiver not sharing their giving with more than one is, I mean, you're probably taking a little bit of hit on profit, but, you know, you're really putting yourself out there as someone who cares so much more for their clients than anything else.
Oh, and another thing we did, for example, some caregivers, they were using public transportation.
Yeah, I wonder about that sometimes.
Or sometimes even, you know, using ride sharing. So we... At times, we hired some, like a private driver, so who can pick up the caregivers, drive them to
that's great.
The client, so they don't have to get into, like, another somebody else's car. They don't know who was there before, or use a bus. So,
yeah, so you're really going out in a big way to
protect
help
your client.
Yeah, protect the clients. Now, and I mean, that's great. And do either one of you guys have, you fellas, gentlemen, whatever we're going to call you, caregiver extraordinaires, have any tips for, especially, you know, a lot of the people that focus on this show or our focus for our listeners is the retired or getting closer to retirement age. Do you have tips or words of wisdom for us? Because I am one of those. I am not only older, I'm very older. Just in general, I don't care how many times people hear some of these things, but let's hear what your recommendations are to keep us in general safe.
Arnold can answer that.
Yes, to keep in shape, you have to be physically healthy, do more exercising, walking, healthy foods, not to be stressed out with what's happening right now. Relax and chill.
Hello.
Yeah, I mean, it is tough. I mean, you know, I guess if I want to be thought of as smart or wise, even though I had absolutely no control over this, I guess I picked a good year to be seriously ill. But, you know, so because I couldn't go out anyway, but that's kind of a joke. But my God, look at what's happening. So, yeah, we have to, as you said earlier, keep washing, which I need to keep reminding myself, because we all need, the thing is, even us oldies, unless they have a caregiver, we need to go out shopping. We need to go to the drugstore. I went out yesterday to the drugstore to get a flu shot. You know, I would say probably get your flu shot as soon as possible, if you can. There is a separate one for older people. You know, anything that will weaken your immune system, like getting the regular flu, will make you more susceptible to COVID-19. And nobody wants that. So I think you guys would agree there. But, you know, we've kind of already covered, but, you know, since we're talking about different healthcare in general, how do you think your company, One Heart, excuse me, let me get my... There we go. Is you know, what sets you apart from other home care companies?
For one thing, of course, Arnold is expert in that because he's been doing, being a client care manager for years, is we not only train our caregivers more than what's required by the state of California, but we put one client care manager for each client. So somebody is monitoring the care 24/7. Make sure.
Wow.
Some agency, they just send some caregivers and that's it, you know, maybe check with them once a week or so.
Mm-hmm.
I know some agencies that they don't do evaluation, but we go through this very carefully. So that's the main thing.
Now, let me repeat something, a question, because I think it's so important for anybody out there who's thinking of getting into this business. Money is wonderful, but it isn't everything. It's not even close to everything. So I'll let both of you chip in here or chime in. How do you really feel when you are, which I'm sure you are, recognized as such a great help to families, and as their elder care advisor, you know, in the community in general? I think that kind of feedback when you get it is probably more important than anything else, except, of course, the health of the people you're looking over.
You need to have passion in helping other people. Of course, in this business, not only elderly people are clients, but also who are in the rehabilitation stage.
Right.
They get injured, they get surgery. So you have to have the compassion to help people.
Right.
And the key word for this business is matching. You have to find the right caregiver for the client that needs care.
Right. But that really makes you guys feel good, doesn't it?
Of
when
course,
you know you're doing so good for the community in general. Now, I am guilty of thinking of older people, and I should, you know, and that's because this show is aimed at older people, and I do reverse mortgages or the home equity conversion, because it seems like it's been proven that people live longer and they're healthier if they stay home. And earlier, I actually mentioned take that nursing home and shove it, but that's another story altogether. And you guys are the ones that keep people out of nursing homes and in their home where they want to be. So it's just such a great thing that your industry is doing. And we've already talked about how different you are than the others in the industry. So just looking at a bigger picture, do you really think One Heart brand has helped facilitate ease of doing business in general in this industry?
Yes. Yes, very much, yes.
Yeah, and I think it also, you know, this is, I mean, let's face it, this is the Starbucks coffee business of this era. This has got to be one of the largest industries as far as forward looking is concerned. We oldies are still alive, and I think they're supposed to be, I think the baby boomers are supposed to be taking over fairly soon for the largest group on this planet before too long. And my God, we all, I mean, unless there's some real bad news and we leave this, we earn our wings early. Unless we do that, we're going to need help, aren't we? And yes. I think that is creating a huge need for what you do, a huge market to get into, and is really, really driving the growth of the industry. But what do you think is really driving the growth of your brand? And I think I can answer that, but I'll let you go ahead.
Cameron, what helps the growth of our business? Of our
industry? Of your brand, basically.
You just nailed it, because the growth of the population, the elderly population, those who need care, because mm-hmm. before it was not like this, so that's where we come in.
It otherwise, wasn't like this because people didn't live as long.
Exactly.
Now, some of us have told ourselves we're going to live forever, like the three of us talking here.
Yes.
I don't think that's 100% true, but you know what? I've told people my, you know, if you can keep me alive just by putting my brain in an aquarium with wires coming out of it, and I can still listen to music and look at things.
Yes.
That's a joke, of course. Keep me around. The thing is, we are being kept around a lot longer.
Yeah.
And we need help to
you're
do
right.
that.
Yes, you're right.
Okay, yes. So we have 1 minute to go. I want to thank you both so, so much. But I want to take part of this minute for you guys to go ahead and give your contact information one more time.
Before we do that, Arnold, do you want to mention the webinar, upcoming webinar quickly, please?
Yes, we do have a webinar again with Jay on Wednesday, October 28th at 4 p.m. Again, it will be on Wednesday, 4 p.m., October 28th. And my contact number again is 949-2323. My email address is arnold.n@oneheartcares.com.
Guys, so I really enjoyed it.
Thank
Let
you.
Me go back to some wisdom I learned as an old man. I'm not crazy, but it's...